Hey there, this is the old gaming geezer. I just wanted to show you where we are currently with my Enterprise bridge. I haven't done a hell of a lot of work on it since my last video. I've done a lot of work on the lighting here and there to try and make that work. I've added more buttons and more screens. I've also added a ceiling with a big massive light. I'm going to say that's wholly entirely accurate because, well, we never see anywhere above. We never see that in the show because there was no ceiling on the set, so it's entirely accurate. So take that from me. I know these things. Over here we have, this is the weapons console, and I can't remember what console that one is right there. Haven't done those yet. These are the last two consoles I have to do. This is the navigational subsystems console, I think, if I remember correctly. There's a screen here that I can't find. I have a blurry photograph of it. I don't know what's on it. It's really hard to tell what it is. It's a big screen, like you can see there, wide. Like that one, but it doesn't look like that. So I've got, you know, buttons, flashy lights, more screens, box console we've seen. Oh, I've adjusted this, the Moray pattern. Looks really nice. Looks really, really nice. Except when I pull out, and it looks shite again. Well, that's just the way things go. Over here, we've seen Scotty's station. It's there. This is environmental station. I like this. I like this a lot. Sometimes there was one of those viewers like this on this station. Sometimes there isn't. There's one over at the Spock station. So I haven't put it in. I might put it in. I've done some cool little screens here, I must say. I like these screens. I've really got the screen thing down now. So they're created in Photoshop as an image, and then they're brought into After Effects as a PSD file, and then I just kind of mask out bits and a timeline, and some bits are masked and some bits are not. And then when you have these dials here, it's just a shape in the background that's moving up and down. So for example, that would be a yellow shape with an orange outline, and it's just behind a mask, so you can only see that much of it going along in the dial. Most of these are animated screens, but not all of them. For example, that's not an animated screen. That's not an animated screen. That's not an animated screen. That was a little bit animated. That one is very animated. This screen here usually portrayed a condition red screen, but this screen that I drew here was seen once or twice, so I decided to put it up. The condition red screen looks fine, but, you know, I've got the red alert klaxon going off there anyway, so I could have put it up, but I decided not to. And we have simple buttons here. And what else have we changed? We haven't really changed anything else. Pretty sure that the starfield was there the last time we did this. Yes, it was. I remember it flicking over like it just stood there. My timing is perfect. Still haven't figured out this, how to get this to animate in and out. I've done a few little tests and a few little tutorials, and all of them failed. So yeah, I fixed the issue with the mapping coordinates on these little switches. If you recall, they were streaking across it, but I fixed it. I figured out what was wrong. It was just a weird mapping error. This is the navigational display, I believe. Don't really know what it is. This is not finished. There's more. It's just textures. It's three discs with textures on it. I need to add more textures to it. I need to add more drawings onto the textures. For example, you can see the ring of numbers around the outside. On the inside of the white ring, well, the outside of the gray ring has also got numbers. I haven't put those in yet. Yeah, I'll be doing that. They're image files, easy to add to them later. The switches down here, there is a clock which is going to be going down there, which I have not modeled yet. I'll be modeling that soon. That is where we are right now. As I said, I've done a little work on the lighting. It takes about 2 hours to compile the lighting for this now. It used to take about half an hour. But I've increased the complexity of the lighting, so these little grills over here are now working okay. The shadows seem to be coming out fine. Something weird about the color of that one. I might have deleted the texture off that black one there. On the right. I'll have to figure that out. I need to put the grills and lights in those ones over there, and the grills and lights in those ones over there. But yeah, pretty happy with the way this is looking. So let's see a couple of high quality renders of this. Enjoy.